of resources. They transform material available in our environment into resources and use them. Classification of resources. These resources can be classified in the following ways: on the basis of origin, biotic and abiotic. On the basis of exhaustibility, renewable and non-renewable. On the basis of ownership, individual, community, national and international. On the basis of status of development, potential, developed stock and reserves. On the basis of origin, biotic resources. These are obtained from biosphere and have life such as human beings, flora and fauna, fisheries, livestock, etc. Abiotic resources. All those things which are composed of non-living things are called abiotic resources. For example, rocks, metals, water and air. On the basis of exhaustibility, renewable resources. The resources which can be renewed or reproduced by physical, chemical or mechanical processes are known as renewable or replenishable resources. For example, solar energy, wind energy, water, forest and wildlife, etc. The renewable resources may further be divided into continuous or flow and biological. Non-renewable resources. These occur over a very long geological time. Minerals and fossil fuels are examples of such resources. These resources take millions of years in their formation. Some of the resources like metals are recyclable and some like fossil fuels cannot be recycled and get exhausted with their use. On the basis of ownership, individual resources. These are owned privately by individuals. In villages, people own land. Urban people own plots, houses and other property, plantation, pasture lands, ponds, water in wells, etc. are some of the examples of resources ownership by individuals. Community owned resources. There are the resources which are accessible to all the members of the community. In village, grazing ground, burial grounds, village ponds, etc. and public parks, picnic spots, playgrounds in urban areas are community-owned resources. National resources. Technically, all the resources belong to the nation. Urban development authorities get empowered by the government to acquire land for constructing roads, canals, railways, etc. All the minerals, water resources, forests, wildlife land within the political boundaries and oceanic area up to 12 nautical miles, 19.2 km from the coast termed as territorial water and resources therein belong to the nation. International resources. There are international institutions which regulate some resources. The oceanic resources beyond 200 km of the exclusive economic zone belong to open ocean and no individual country can utilize these without the concurrence of international institutions. On the basis of status of development, potential resources. Resources which are found in a region but have not been utilized. For For example, the western parts of India, particularly Rajasthan and Gujarat, have enormous potential for the development of wind and solar energy. But so far, these have not been developed properly. Developed resources. Resources which are surveyed and their quality and quantity have been determined for utilization. The development of resources depends on technology, a level of their feasibility. Stock. Materials in the environment which have the potential to satisfy human needs, but human beings do not have the appropriate technology to access, these are included among stock. For example, hydrogen and oxygen present in air can be used as a rich source of energy, but we do not have the required technology to use them for this purpose. Hence, it can be considered as stock. Reserves are the subset of the stock which can be used with the help of existing technical know-how, but their use has not been started. This can be used to meet the future requirements. River water can be used to generate electric power, but presently it is being utilized only to a limited extent. Thus, the water in the river is a reserve which can be used in the future.